Oh yeah, the Blue Bomber himself. Mega Man is one of the most iconic video game characters of all time, and Capcom clearly gives him the love he deserves. Okay, maybe not. But we're gonna give him some love by chronicling the entire Mega Man timeline, all the way from the classic series to Mega Man X to Legends. Just a couple of notes. Command Mission is non-canon, and the Battle Network series is a completely separate timeline, but we'll explain more about those later. On to the robot slaying goodness. 19XX, Light and Wily Origins. The millennia-spanning saga starts out in the late 20th century with two brilliant young scientists. Dr. Thomas Light and Dr. Albert Wily are both top students at the Robot Institute of Technology. They're good friends at first, but sadly, that friendship morphs into a bitter rivalry. Although they're both geniuses, Light often gets more rewards and recognition, leaving the slightly less brilliant Wily on the sidelines. Light soon develops Light Labs to use his genius in robotics for the betterment of mankind. 2000X, Mega Man series, 1-3 and Wily Wars. Around the turn of the century, Light Labs dives into artificial intelligence research and creates the first ever robot with free will, Proto Man. But since Light kinda messed up Proto Man's power core, he needs to repair him with a procedure that would potentially take that free will away. It's like a heart operation in exchange for a lobotomy. So Proto Man says hell no and runs away, collapsing because, you know, he's got a messed up power core. Wily finds him and repairs him while adding some neato combat enhancements. Light's next attempts at playing God results in two more obedient robots, Rock and Roll, a brother-sister lab assistant housekeeper duo. Now that his domestic comforts are taken care of, Light creates six efficient industrial robots, such as Iceman and Fireman, capable of saving millions in labor costs. Because of this, Light earns the coveted Nobel Prize, but that's the absolute last straw for the jealous Wily. Using the knowledge gained from rebuilding Proto Man, Wily hijacks these industrial behemoths and reprograms them for world domination. Light, desperate to save the world from his own creations, turns to his pure-hearted lab assistant. To stop Wily, Rock volunteers to be cybernetically enhanced into Mega Man, an adaptable machine of justice. He makes quick work of Guts Man and the other robot's masters before defeating Wily for the first of many times. The next year, Wily builds 8 brand new robot masters specifically designed for combat. He almost tricks Mega Man with a nifty alien hologram, but the Blue Bomber thwarts him once more. After a quick Game Boy romp recycling robot masters, Wily tricks Light into helping him make 8 new masters. Now Proto Man is ready to join the fight against Mega Man. Fortunately, Proto Man feels his debt is paid to Wily and ultimately helps out our hero, but he still doesn't trust Dr. Light. Oh, and Mega Man has a robot dog now named Rush. Dr. Wily then uses a time machine to go back and this time win the past 3 adventures, but history is doomed to repeat itself and he fails once again. 20XX, Mega Man series continued, 4-11. Soon after, Mega Man and Light are assaulted by a mysterious Russian scientist, Dr. Kosak. But it turns out he's really just being blackmailed by the rascally Dr. Wily. Around this time, Wily jumps to the future and reprograms Mega Man's future self named Quint. Then he manages to take over the world's oceans with a robot punk. But again, these Game Boy ROMs are mere child's play for a seasoned robot hero. Back on the NES, Wily uses Dark Man to kidnap Dr. Light and frame Proto Man, but thanks to Robo Bird Beat and the real Proto Man, he fails once more. More obscure adventures soon follow, including battling Rockman killer Balad, a robot alien invasion of star droids, and even an interactive movie to the Amazon. Mr. X, Wily, holds a Robot Olympics as a means of getting the world's strongest robots to do his bidding. But of course, Mega Man foils all of their efforts combined. At this point, Wily decides to pour all of his efforts into developing one ultimate foil for Mega Man, Bass, and also a foil for his dog named Treble. But Wily makes Bass a bit too proud, who ultimately betrays his creator, ashamed of Wily's incompetence. Bass eventually teams up with Proto Man and Mega Man to tackle recreated past adventures in Mega Man: The Power Battle. Soon, Mega Man learns how to dribble a soccer ball as 2 giant space robots crash into Earth, giving Wily the materials and tech he needs to strike once again. But even on the PS1, Bass and Wily fall to the righteous Rockman. Yeah, Rockman is Mega Man's original name, you guys already knew that. At least this time, Mega Man has some help from an intergalactic police force robot duo. Anti-hero Bass has to join the light side once more as Wily unleashes a new robot royalty upon the world, King. This guy loses his crown quickly enough, but Wily isn't quite done tinkering. Mega Man 2, The Power Fighters, reveals the beginning developments of an even more powerful super weapon and foil to Mega Man, Zero. Not only that, but Wily also implants Zero with a robot corrupting Maverick virus. However, it'll be years and years until Zero awakens. For now, Mega Man and Bass team up again to fight an enemy from the future known as R-Shadow and the Dimensions before moving on to a strategy adventure against the Constellation Droids. Around this time, Light develops the successor to Mega Man, X, the robot with the ultimate potential. But X is also far from ready, and will take several more decades to fully develop. Light realizes he'll never truly see his ultimate creation, so he seals X away for a long, long slumber. Eight more of Light's industrial robot masters are nearing the end of their government-issued life cycle and are about to be decommissioned. So Wily manipulates them to rebel, framing Light in the process. Returning to his retro roots, Mega Man thwarts Wily again with the help of Proto Man. But it isn't long before a new kind of threat emerges. Robo-Enza, a pandemic designed by Wily, infects most of the robot community, including Mega Man's sister, Roll. Mega Man chases Wily all the way to space, but it turns out that Wily is also sick with a human virus. Mega Man spares Wily and gets him to a hospital, and in return, Wily gives him the Robo-Enza cure for Roll. Perhaps Wily has turned a new leaf. Nah, he's back for Mega Man 11 with the Double Gear system he developed back in college. This system greatly increases the power of robots while simultaneously dangerously destabilizing them. Wily hijacks 8 more robots and implements this system, leaving Mega Man no option but to Double Gear himself and take the upgraded Robot Masters and Nefarious Doctor down one final time. 21XX, Mega Man X Series. By the 22nd century, Wily, Light, and Mega Man are dead and forgotten, but archaeologist Dr. Kane suddenly makes a startling discovery. It's X! Kane is able to use the lost technology within X to reverse engineer a new breed of advanced robots, the Reploids. These replications of X are meant to be AI-enhanced servants, but occasionally, the free will within these Reploids causes them to go rogue. To combat these Maverick Reploids, Maverick Hunters are developed as bounty hunters of sorts. Over time, Sigma emerges as the Alpha Maverick Hunter, the dog of the Maverick Hunters, if you will. More dispensable Maverick Hunters uncover an abandoned Wily lab, where they awaken the incubated superweapon Zero. The miscellaneous Reploids stand no chance against Zero, so Sigma's crew is called in for the fight. It's a hard-fought battle, and Sigma is on the verge of defeat. But suddenly, he breaks the glowing crystal on Zero's head, incapacitating Zero, but unleashing the Maverick virus and infecting Sigma. Zero gets taken back to Dr. Kane and is eventually resurrected as pure as a Boy Scout. Ultimately, he becomes a Maverick Hunter as respected as Sigma. Meanwhile, X is still a rapidly learning, albeit naive, young robot eager to join the ranks of Zero and the other Hunters. He is nearing maturity when suddenly, the Maverick virus takes hold of Sigma, fully corrupting his programming and turning him against humanity. Sigma convinces the Reploids that their human creators are holding them back, causing widespread revolt. But Zero and X remain uncorrupted. Zero springs into action, with X eager to help, but the naive youngster is soon beaten down by Sigma's right hand, Vile. Zero bails him out, and X goes on to take down 8 defected Maverick Hunters, and soon becoming as powerful as Zero, fulfilling his destiny as the robot with the ultimate potential. After Zero sacrifices himself to help destroy the maniacal Vile, X finally defeats Sigma all on his own. A few months later, X has to deal with nefarious X Hunters who try to steal Zero's scattered body parts. X beats them to the punch, reassembling his friend and defeating Copy Zero and Neo Sigma. If you don't collect his parts though, you end up having to fight Zero instead, only to have him help X anyway. X then has to rebattle some revived enemies in cyberspace thanks to Shadow Hunter hackers. It's a pretty extreme situation. Robot scientist Dr. Doppler finally creates a cure for the Maverick virus, so all infected Reploids are gathered to a robot utopia. Of course, it's all a ruse. The cure is fake. Sigma is controlling Doppler, and this newly amassed army attack the Maverick Hunters. But even this army and the Nightmare Police stand no chance against the reunited X and Zero. Next up is a fun island adventure to prevent Reploid erasure all over the world. Again, super extreme situations our heroes are dealing with. A military force of Reploids, known as Repliforce, is established, but soon framed for Magma Dragoon's destruction of Sky Lagoon City. Shockingly, Sigma is the puppet master behind this giant Repliforce war of Maverick Hunters versus Repliforce. This whole misunderstanding gets resolved after a noble sacrifice by the Repliforce general named... General. After constructing pretty much all of this century's problems, Dr. Kane decides to call it quits and retire. But before he does, he creates one more Reploid to lead the Maverick Hunters, Cygnus. By this point, the world is colonizing the neighboring space near Earth. Everything's pretty rad, until the artificial gravity system of one of these colonies, Eurasia, gets corrupted by a new virus and starts careening towards Earth. Oh yeah, and Sigma's back again, and he's unleashed the Sigma virus once more. When the colony collides with Earth, the Sigma virus mixes with the colony virus, creating something called called the Zero Virus. Oh, and the resulting chaos turns Zero Maverick. Maybe. Yeah, PS1 really stepped up the plot. X fights his friend to snap him out of it, but Sigma shows up to ruin everyone's day. Zero nobly sacrifices himself to save X, proving his pure heart and buying enough time for Kane's hologram to save X a la Obi-Wan Kenobi. A few weeks later, and humans are forced to live underground as Reploids clean up the viral mess on the surface. A Reploid scientist named Gate discovers a ghost-like viral Nightmare Zero in the rubble, and it quickly turns more Reploids Maverick. But it turns out Gate actually developed this nightmare himself using Zero's DNA. To make matters worse, he resurrects Sigma too. X and his somehow still alive Zero take down their revived nemesis while sparing the mad scientist. By this point, Zero begins to wonder if he's too much a liability for humanity. Roughly a decade later, Reploids are continuing to advance as next-generation Reploids with data replication capabilities. Meanwhile, X is getting tired of saving the world all the damn time. So when X abandons his peacekeeping duties, the vigilante group Red Alert Syndicate picks up the slack. Axel, a brash young Red Alert member, ditches their violent ways to join up with the Maverick Hunters instead. When the Syndicate demands he be returned, violence breaks out. Oh, and turns out that Sigma has been manipulating Red Alert the whole time. Zero, Axel, and, after what feels like forever, X storm the Red Alert base. Red Alert's leader, Red, overcomes his horrible case of Sigma blackmail and redeems himself with a sacrifice before the big bad gets taken down for the 7th or 9th time or whatever. Axel mourns the loss of Red and officially becomes a Maverick Hunter. A year or so later, Vile returns to attack Jacob's Tower, a giant orbital elevator being constructed by the next generation data copying Reploids. Sigma plans to infect them all with his own DNA, granting them all his unique ability to turn Maverick but keep their free will. Well, this time, Sigma is actually the puppet. This diabolical plan was actually hatched by Jacob's Tower director and next generation Reploid, Lumine. Axel, Zero, and X defeat this mastermind and Sigma for the final time, and it all goes down on the moon. And then, the gang takes a quick trip to cyberspace via smartphones. Well, in Japan at least. Zero seals himself away for the safety of mankind while his mind is studied to create cyber elves, sentient cyber beings capable of enhancing the abilities of any Reploid. That's how the powerful Mother Elf gets created. X uses this mega weapon to destroy the Sigma virus and end the Maverick Wars once and for all. But security for the Mother Elf is light, and the evil Dr. Wile nabs it and transforms it into the Dark Elf, kickstarting the horrific Elf Wars. In just 4 years, more than half of humanity and almost all of Reploid kind are completely destroyed. During the carnage, Zero is revived and forced to transfer his consciousness into Copy Zero. Wile uses Zero's original body to create the super weapon Devil Reploid Omega. Copy Zero and X work together to temporarily beat Omega and end the bloodshed. But now, Zero really feels responsible. His hyper-advanced mind and body led to all this death, so he seals himself away once more to give the world a chance to recover. 22XX, Mega Man Zero series. Okay, so Mega Man X Command Mission takes place in this 23rd century, where the Maverick Hunters have to strategically battle a band of rebelling Reploids on the island nation of Giga City. That takes place in a non-canon universe where Zero doesn't seal himself away, which he totally does. So in the canon timeline, X has since created the wondrous utopian city of Neo Arcadia. The Dark Elf is still on the loose, so X sacrifices his body to contain it, while his consciousness becomes a cyber elf. That's okay, he was tired of fighting anyway. Now, Neo Arcadia is freaking out since they don't have a leader, so the young genius scientist CL creates a perfect copy of X called Copy X. But remember how long it took for X to mature? Like 100 years. And it turns out having an immature child emperor isn't exactly the best idea. Copy X blames Reploids for energy shortages and begins to wipe them out. The Reploids form a feeble resistance, and CL sets out to revive Zero. With the help and sacrifice of her cyber elf Passy, CL finds and revives the dormant Zero. He's not exactly thrilled with what the world's been up to during his slumber, and agrees to single-handedly take down Copy X and the corrupt forces of Neo Arcadia. After stopping Copy X, Zero wanders the desert for a bit as the war rages on. The insecure El Piso now leads the resistance, and this asshat thinks it's a bright idea to merge with the Dark Elf to take out Neo Arcadia forces. With help from Cyber Elf X, Zero rushes to intercept El Piso. He's a moment too late. Although the souped-up El Piso is ultimately defeated and turned into a Cyber Elf, the nefarious Dark Elf is now free. With his coveted prize ripe for the taking, Dr. Wile and Omega return to Earth from space, reviving Copy X and taking control of Neo Arcadia. They locate the Dark Dark Elf and merge her with Omega, creating an ultra-powerful being. But Zero is more battle-hardened than ever, so he overcomes the revived Copy X and even the Dark Alpha-fied Omega. But he hesitates to finish Omega off, as he'd be destroying his own old body. But Cyber Elf X shows up to be like, yo, you kidding? Look at me, it could be worse. And Zero deals the finishing blow. With Dr. Wiles' curse lifted, the Dark Elf is able to transform back into the pure Mother Elf once more. But unfortunately, the mad scientist still has control of Neo Arcadia. Humans do their best to escape this tyrannical rule, but he plans to destroy every habitable area outside of Neo Arcadia via satellite. That way, people have nowhere to run to. Ish. Zero boards this Ragnarok satellite to battle Dr. Wile, but the scientist uploads his consciousness into Ragnarok, becoming nearly invincible. Yet, Zero prevails, and with the satellite, humans and Reploids are able to live in peace in the newly settled Area Zero. But when the Ragnarok Wile hybrid exploded, it didn't exactly disappear. Chunks of it started raining down to the surface below. 24XX, Mega Man ZX series. Centuries later, a new mad scientist named Albert discovers these chunks and uses them to create Model W, a controllable biometal that can be used to create havoc-wreaking Mavericks once again. Peacekeepers known as Guardians eventually track down the source of this radiating dark power. They use Model W to create more biometals, including Model X and Model Z, which contain the DNA of X and Zero. Serpent, head of renewable energy company Serpent Inc., is driven mad by the allure of Model W. He nabs it, massacring any Guardian standing in his way. The Guardians need a savior to fight against Serpent's unlimited resources. They discover Vent and or Isle as the perfect biomatch for Model X. Throughout their adventure, they gain additional biometals, and by combining the powers of Model X and Model Z, they become the ultimate Mega Man ZX. This chosen one defeats Serpent and a saved memory file of Omega and accepts their destiny as hero. A few years later, Gray and or Ash are the new Reploids chosen to harness the power of various biometals and fight against corrupted Mega Men controlled by Albert. Albert's actually the father slash creator of this new protagonist, and he plans to hyper-accelerate Reploid and human advancement as part of a twisted, purist fever dream. He finally gathers the world's Model W and recreates Ragnarok in the form of the ultimate biometal Ouroboros. Gray and or Ash overcome their mad scientist maker, and the world enjoys some peace for the next few millennia. Albert's colleague Thomas seems to have embraced his evil partner's research and goals, but I really doubt this cliffhanger is going to be resolved anytime soon. Several thousand years later, fast forward a few millennia to the utopian world known as Elysium. Elysium creates and watches over artificially made humans known as Carbons. It also houses the last true human in existence named the Master. After 3,000 years, he's bored as hell, so he becomes chummy with Mega Man Trigger, an ultra-powerful purifier whose job is to wipe out any cosmic threat to the Carbons. The Master has Mega Man Trigger take him to the Carbons' world, Terra. He sees how happy the frolicking Carbons are, despite facing hardships like hunger and death. He realizes that they're better off without Elysium's constant eye, and orders Mega Man Trigger to destroy the watchful Master System before dying. But Sarah, the mother unit guardian of Elysium, stops Mega Man before he can do so. They fight till they're both unconscious, and Yuna, mother unit of Terra, seals them both away. She seals Sarah on Forbidden Island and seals Mega Man Trigger on Nino Island. He's reduced to an infant form while recovering, and his memory is transferred to his robot monkey, Data. Several more thousand years later, Mega Man Legends series. Terra is a completely waterlogged world. Carbon diggers hop island to island in search of precious resources like refractors. Many diggers disappear in the vicious storms that guard the Forbidden Island, including Banner and Matilda. These poor missing souls leave behind the orphaned Roll Casket to be raised by her grandpa Beryl. Beryl discovers baby Mega Man Trigger and Data on Nino Island and decides to raise them as well, renaming Trigger Mega Man Volnut. A few years later, pirate Tron Bon has her own misadventures and pays off her brother's debts to fund the massive battle ship Gesellschaft. Now, the whole Casket orphanage works as diggers and crash lands on Catalox Island, which just so happens to house unimaginable treasures and dark secrets. Mega Man explores the island while fighting off hordes of treasure-hungry Bond pirates. He befriends numerous islanders and collects various refractors throughout Catalox Island to beat the pirates to wealth and glory. Volnut thwarts the bumbling Tron and Teasel Bond at every turn, eventually uncovering the great treasure. But he finds more than just a giant refractor. He also awakens the ultra-cold Mega Man Juno. Juno explains that Mega Man Trigger's destiny was to wipe out the Carbons once they reached a certain maturity. Juno was set to destroy Catalox and begin fulfilling this fate, but Volnut overcomes this final boss with help from the reformed Bond siblings. Juno almost backs up his memory to fulfill his purpose, but Data uses the ancient knowledge within Mega Man Trigger's memories to thwart this data transfer. The day is saved, and the pirates sneakily make off with a giant refractor as a prize. Grandpa Beryl is still searching for the treasure Motherlode, so he uses his new super ship, Sulphur Bottom, to finally explore explore the stormy Forbidden Island. They're nearly destroyed in the process, but Volnut and Roll come to their rescue. When they reach Forbidden Island, they discover that Roll's mom, Matilda, didn't actually die. Yuna revived her, but had to temporarily sacrifice her own body and occupy Matilda's to do so. Mega Man's arrival to Forbidden Island also reawakens Sarah at last, so the epic battle from millennia prior is about to come to a head once more. Sarah is set to activate the Carbon Reinitialization Program. Sure, it'll revive humans, but it'll also kill all carbons. The conflict makes its way all the way back to Elysium. During the final confrontation, Sarah is overwhelmed by Yura and Volnut, and eventually has a change of heart. I mean, after all, the Master clearly didn't want the carbons to die. I mean, come on, duh, Sarah. The threat's gone, but Yura, Sarah, and Mega Man Volnut are still stranded on Elysium. Roll wants to build a rescue rocket with the pirates' help, but it looks like they might be stuck there forever. Seriously, Mega Man Legends 3 got canceled, like, almost 10 years ago. And okay, I know that the Battle Network and Star Force games aren't part of the main timeline, but they're totally worth mentioning. Mega Man Battle Network and Mega Man Star Force. In a completely parallel universe, all technology is connected to the internet. Like, even more so than now. Children use computer programs like Megaman.exe to enter a computer world and battle hackers and Trojan horses alike. These tactical RPGs definitely deserve their own timeline video, so please let us know if you'd like us to tackle that next. Or let us know if we should go more in depth into a specific Mega Man series. We just tackled about 40 games, and certainly can go into way more detail. For more Mega Man and timelines like this one, be sure to subscribe to the leaderboard. All players, Reploids, and Robot Masters are welcome. I'm your host, Marcus. Thanks for watching.